Hey, sorry. I'm Adam Chernick, R&D lead for AR/VR at SHoP Architects in New York City.
I'm Christopher Morse, associate of interactive visualization at SHoP Architects in New York City.
I was always in architecture. I thought that I was going to go the traditional route, and then I found out about augmented reality. My first thought was, I need to learn how to do that.
Designers are constantly iterating and constantly changing their designs, and so they'll give me something on one day and I have to import it, bring it into Unity, and then by the next day it's already changed and I have to go through that entire process again. Now with Reflect, I don't have to do anything. I just build it once. They just have to hit the button on their end to send the data and it's done.
My reaction was, wow, this is what we've been waiting for.
I think we spent like just half an hour moving something in Revit and it moves over here and move another thing and it moves over here. It was a lot of fun just to play with that. After watching things move, we take something else that we'd already built and just drag and drop the Reflect package in there and watch it work.
This is a very, very welcome technology for us. We get to dive in and see how you guys did it, and then that kind of informs a lot of, you know, decisions that we make.
Just internally in our design reviews, somebody has an idea and they're trying to communicate it to the partner, communicate it to the rest of the team. If they can communicate that more clearly, they're going to get better feedback, better results. The building is going to be better. If we can use something like Unity Reflect to change that communication and improve that communication, we can save time and cost in terms of fixing mistakes.
We are using archaic methods for building buildings still. We started with hand drawing, two-dimensional drawings. Then we got in the computer, started using CAD to make two-dimensional drawing faster. Now we're three-dimensionally modeling in order to make two-dimensional drawing faster. That is why we're three-dimensional modeling. How do we bypass, you know, us sending our construction documents to a general contractor who sends them to a subcontractor who sends them out to get shop drawings done, who then send them back to us to verify and then send them back to them? How do we go directly from us to the fabricator? With the right team and with the right partners in the industry, we can get this done.